Wait, before you head down to the comments and give me a piece of your mind about the title of this video, hear me out. This video is not here to say the Paradigm X15 is better than the JTR RS2's in any way. Today's video is more about unboxing and giving my first impressions on the X15s, but there are a lot of you out there asking me why I even sold my JTR RS2's because they are an endgame subwoofer, so I'm going to answer that question in today's video as well. A lot of times us audio guys, especially us home theater guys, get hung up on infrasonic output. I'm very guilty of this myself, but infrasonics, which means the frequencies that provide a tactile response but can't be heard, should not always be the main focus, and it is far from the whole story of any subwoofer. Not everyone cares about infrasonics. In fact, lately I've started to put a little less emphasis on infrasonics myself. Sure, they can be a lot of fun, and they can shake your doors and your windows, but for me personally, they have kind of lost their novelty a little bit. I know, even I'm shocked to hear myself say that. But today's video is not a comparison between the JTR RS2s and the Paradigm X15s. We all know that these subwoofers are in a different class, and it is far from apples to apples in comparison, but I will draw some comparisons in my explanation as far as my first impressions in sound, simply to help you guys understand what I'm hearing. With all that said, the Paradigm Defiance X15 subwoofers do have some positive attributes that even shakes up my subwoofer beliefs and foundation. We are going to get into all that in today's video. I'm Barrett, this is Speck of Tech. Grab a comfy seat and let's talk about the Paradigm Defiance X15 subwoofers. First things first, guys, I do want to thank my local dealer, Bass Electronics, which is where I purchased these subwoofers. If you guys are in the Calgary area, you do need to check them out. They are one of the few great audio businesses left here in Calgary. The general manager, John, is a stand-up guy that always looks after me. He even drove across the city twice to help deliver these subwoofers. So thank you, John. You are one heck of a guy. But before we get into my first impressions, let's get into these boxes. I do have four of these Paradigm X15s, but we're only going to unbox one on the camera, just because once you've seen one unboxed, you've seen them all. Hey guys, as you can see, we're kind of behind my home theater seating here. This subwoofer is going to be placed behind the seating, so I figured why not unbox it here. You may be able to see I already unboxed one of them, because I wanted to see kind of how to unbox it so I could show it to you guys. We only need to really unbox one of them in front of the camera. But you'll have to excuse me too, it's kind of warm in here. We're going through a bit of a heat wave here in Canada, which isn't common. It doesn't often get hot here, so we don't have AC. But I'm feeling pretty warm, and I'm doing a whole bunch of shooting and moving things today, so I'm already kind of heated up. So you'll have to excuse me, I am gonna get pretty warm on this. But let's get into this box of the Paradigm Defiance X15 subwoofer. Don't be a dummy like me and open it from the top. It does say right here, stop, open from the other end. So let's flip this box over and open it from the bottom like they want you to. Okay. And it does have some staples, so just take some of the tape and then pry it apart. And then inside here, you have your arc room correction kit. So yes, these do have arc built in for individual calibration of the subwoofers. You can also calibrate them together. Then you have a little bit of paperwork, like a quick start guide, some spike feet in this little package here with a manual, and then your power cable. And that's pretty much all you have in the box other than the subwoofer itself. So let me just get this piece out of the way. And I already have a whole bunch of styrofoam here from the other ones I have unboxed. And then we have the grill in a little box here, which I'll show you guys in a bit once we get this thing out. And once you have that out, just open up the plastic so that you don't put the subwoofer on top of it and make it harder to get it off once you flip it over. You can take off a little white sheet. So here's the port on the bottom of the subwoofer. And then we just kind of flip this over. And make sure just to hold the subwoofer so it doesn't fall. One giant box. It's very awkward, really, especially with limited space, as you can see me struggle with it. But here's the subwoofer. There is
the 15-inch driver with their ARC or active ridge technology surround. Pretty simple subwoofer, guys. That's the unboxing. You can see there's feet on the bottom that are probably about an inch tall. But let's get some more footage of it and let's talk about it up close and personal.
Each one of these units is $14.99, which kind of puts it in competition with the SVS PB3000, which is priced at $13.99. These X15s aren't exactly small, but they aren't too big either. I would say they're kind of on the larger side of medium. They're almost a 24-inch cube measuring 24 5/8 inches high, 23 3/16 inches wide, and 24 5/8 inches deep, and weigh in at 92 pounds, which is quite light considering what I'm used to. The 15-inch carbon-loaded polypropylene driver is equipped with Paradigm's active ridge technology, which is why it looks ribbed for your subwoofer pleasure. Paradigm claims this gives the subwoofer more output, less distortion, and better linearity. I'm not sure exactly what a carbon-loaded driver is, but I would think it's fair to assume that it's carbon-infused polypropylene. Pushing the carbon-loaded cone is an 800-watt RMS and 1800-watt peak Class D amplifier. According to Paradigm, this subwoofer is capable of a frequency response of 18Hz to 240Hz, plus or minus 3dB, with an in-room response down to 14Hz. Stay tuned for my full review, I will measure the subwoofer in my room with Rue to confirm how low it can go. When it comes to build quality, it is pretty standard, but it is quite well built at the same time. Paradigm uses 1-inch MDF for the cabinet with a black vinyl wrap by the looks of it. It may not be the prettiest subwoofer around or the prettiest subwoofer that I've owned, but it isn't bad looking either. One thing to bear in mind is that there was no effort to round out any of the edges or corners, so they are pretty sharp. To help prevent you from bursting your toe open on the sharp corners are 1.5-inch feet lifting it off the ground, which have a grippy rubber base. For those who want to place these on carpet, there are carpet spikes included in the box. They also do include a grill, but they are attached with my arch nemesis, the peg and grommet fasteners. I hope that Paradigm changes to magnetic grills in the future. It's 2022, guys. Use some magnets. Alright guys, so let's talk about my first impressions on the sound, and after that I'll explain why I sold the JTR subwoofers. But real quick before we do, if you made it this far, why not subscribe? Tick the bell icon if you do, and please take just one tiny second to hit that like button. Alright, so back to the sound. So when it comes to the sound, the biggest difference I noticed when switching to the X15, I can only describe it by weight. The RS2 has this heavy, thick sort of bass, not only in the low end, but in their punchy bass as well. When compared to the X15 has a lighter bass. Not that it doesn't shake the room as well, but it has a lighter feel to it. This is especially true for the punchy bass. I feel as though because the driver is lighter, it has a faster, impactful punch, but at the same time, it has less weight to it. The X15s hit hard and sharp. The RS2s do hit hard as well, but it was less sharp. I hope this all makes sense. I'm trying to do my best here to help you guys understand. This really is hard to explain because when it comes to plain SPL numbers, the RS2 takes an easy win over the X15s at all frequencies. The RS2s could shake the house with authority and weight. The X15s can shake my room with authority, but it shakes the house with less authority. And of course, I also noticed that the X15s don't extend as low in frequency. They do have some infrasonics that is capable of shaking doors and windows, but definitely do not reach down to 7Hz like my JTRs do. Overall, I'm actually not disappointed in the X15s at all. They do hit nice and hard and still have good output between 15 and 20Hz. With using 4 of them, my room is definitely not lacking in the bass department. Not that I was ever even close to lacking with the output on the JTRs. So that kind of sums up my first impressions on the X15, guys. Make sure you stay tuned for the review, but let's get into why I sold the JTRs. There are actually several reasons that got me to the point of selling the JTRs. These aren't in any particular order. They're not really ranked as far as like most important to least important, because there wasn't really one reason that got me to this point. It was an accumulation of all my reasons. But before we talk about my reasons for selling, I do want to clarify one thing. Having three or four high-performance subwoofers in my space was something that I wanted to experience. I was going to accomplish this goal regardless, so I don't regret it. It was something I wanted to do, and I'm happy that I experienced it. To me, it was an investment on audio knowledge that I can now speak on based on firsthand experience, and it was a lot of fun along the way as well. Okay, so reason number one that I sold the JTRs is all about the dollar bills, guys. The economy seems to be taking a massive dip along with crazy levels of inflation, which could also be an argument not to sell them because the price will only go up from here on the JTRs, so if I did want them in the future, they're going to be more expensive. But I chose to look at it from the standpoint of, do I really need $15,000 Canadian in subwoofers? Inflation is going crazy, and my wage certainly is not going up with it. Despite what some might think, I'm not making much money on YouTube either. So one of the reasons was financially motivated. Selling the subwoofers and getting less expensive ones puts money in my pocket. Another reason that goes hand in hand with the question, do I really need $15,000 Canadian in subwoofers, is do I really need 12,000 watts and 6 18-inch drivers in my space? I, along with many of you, knew the answer to this question before I bought the JTR RS2s. The answer is of course no, there's just way too much subwoofer here, regardless of the fact that my room is 25 feet by 17 with 8-foot ceilings and is open to the rest of the 4-level split home. Unless you're literally looking for bass that will cause physical damage to your home over time, I am a bass head, but I don't want to wreck my house. This to me was a goal I wanted to accomplish so I could experience it for myself. Once I accomplished it, I needed to decide if I needed to continue with it or start thinking more realistically. For the time being, I am venturing down the path of more realistic. So another reason that I sold them was that I had decided to sell one of the JTRs simply because I can't use them to their full potential unless I want to wreck stuff, so there was no need for me to have three. So I posted one for sale and the response was actually overwhelming. These were in such high demand in Canada because I guess they're much more difficult to get. After selling one of them, I had to decide if I wanted to sell the other two because I was getting asked by several potential buyers. So the demand was there for me to sell them if I wanted to. Selling them would allow me to shop for less expensive subwoofers, which of course would be good content for my channel, so that was another reason that kind of pushed me towards selling. But it also raised another question in my head. Could I accomplish the same extreme sort of bass that I like for less money? Of course, keeping some of the sacrifices in mind, like the fact that any subwoofer I would spend less money on would not have the same output as the JTRs, that's just facts. This to me is all part of the journey of this hobby. Personally, the journey for me is just as much the hobby as the end goal and the audio itself. In addition to that, I had ordered more Krosen actuators back in November 2021, and they were finally able to get enough parts to complete some of their backlog orders, so my Krosens had now come in, which allowed for me to add more to my chairs. The Krosens provide incredibly accurate feeling tactile bass down to 5 Hz, so could the Krosens, along with 4 subwoofers that provide good output down to 15 Hz and great output above 30 Hz, fulfill my bass needs and get me close to what I was experiencing with the JTRs while still spending less money? Of course, with buying 4 subwoofers, I was able to negotiate on price, so there was a little bit of savings there as well, essentially more money in my pocket after selling the JTRs. I also wanted to have some of the extra money to put towards a new hobby. I would like to get into e-dirt biking and go riding around my city as well as the nearby Rocky Mountains. I was riding dirt bikes and off-road vehicles since I was about 9 until I was in my early 20s, and then after that I was riding road bikes, and it is something I sorely miss and would love to get back into before I'm too old to enjoy it. So again, that one comes down to money. E-dirt bikes are not cheap. Selling the JTRs would allow for me to be able to afford one of the e-dirt bikes. And the final reason is that I had also made plans to sell the Paradigm Founder speakers, so it worked out nicely to sell those and the JTRs all at once. I will be replacing the Paradigms with some slightly less expensive Sonos Fobbers. Because I was buying a full 7 speaker setup, again I was able to negotiate on price and not pay full retail, which again allowed for me to put a little money in my pocket. So make sure to stay tuned for some Sonos Fobber speaker content coming soon. These reasons kind of sum up the whole path that brought me to selling some of the best subwoofers available on the commercial market, the JTR RS2s. I do love the JTRs. There is absolutely nothing negative that I can say about them. Selling them had nothing to do with not liking them or not being happy with them. They truly are one of the best sealed subwoofers on the market, full stop. And when you take their price into account, it makes them even more of a value. If you are looking for a subwoofer that provides extreme clean output with a small footprint, just buy the RS2s. No hype, no fanboyism, these subwoofers truly are amazing. There you have it, guys. Those are the reasons that brought me to selling my JTR RS2s. I know I will get some colorful comments, so drop your thoughts down below. Stay tuned for some Paradigm X15 content. Do you think I can get the bass experience I crave with 4 X15s and the Krosen actuators? We'll have to find out in the future videos. Subscribe to the channel if you do want to find out. Tick the bell icon if you do subscribe. And please take just one short second to hit that like button. I truly do appreciate it. And if you'd like to support the channel so that I can keep bringing you videos like this, consider joining me on Patreon. The link is down in the description below. Or you can become a member of the channel by hitting the join button right below this video. Remember to enjoy your systems. I'll see you on the next one. Cheers.